Today, we're going to talk about scanning and Tenable Vulnerability Management. To begin, we're going to click on Menu in the top left-hand corner and choose Scans. Notice you got two different types of scans. You got a web application scan, which is, once again, it's pretty much geared towards websites and web application. It checks for things like Node.js version, PHP versions. If you're not familiar with those terms, but those are typically things used when it comes to web application development. We're going to look at the vulnerability management scan specifically today. And we're going to basically go over some of the ones that are very common. So if you're just new to Tenable, then these are kind of the scans that you're going to want to run in most environments. So what we're going to do here is we're going to click Create Scan in the top right hand corner. And let's talk about the different kind of scans seen here. Typically, when you go into Tenable Vulnerability Management, you're going to do a basic network scan is one. Like, these are kind of the essential ones. Basic network scan, host discovery scan. And then also, if you click on the Nessus agent menu here, the basic agent scan. The reason why I recommend these is because they don't really require a lot of configuration and stuff like that when you're getting started. And so these are some of the ones that are really critical. So the agent scan, this is a piece of software on a machine like the Nessus agent, and that's going to be able to assess vulnerabilities. The host discovery scan allows you to, once again, you do have to understand networking. This is why I always emphasize this, because you want to scan different subnets on your company's network or your home network or whatever you're running this on. You need to understand, and that means you have to have a Nessus scanner installed on at least one machine on each subnet or each network segment that you want to scan. And then the basic network scan allows you to be able to scan internally and externally. So this can be scanning from that same machine that you have a Nessus scanner on, or you can be scanning from the internet. And so we'll talk about that in just a second. So the scan that I use most of the time is going to be the Nessus agent scan. And this means we have to go and we have to install the Nessus agent on the machine, but you also have to install the Nessus scanner. When I click basic agent scan, I'm just going to show you the information that you require. So right now it's just the name, the agent group. So that means in Tenable, you have to go into the agent section, which is down here in the sensors, and you have to create a group and put the agents in a group. And once the agents are in the group, then you can select them from the list. So if you go here and it only says add an agent to a group or is blank or whatever like that, that means you haven't created a group. So you just go to sensors, and I'll show you this, sensors, and you go to agent and agent groups, and you create a group here. That's simple. Okay, so let's go back to scans. We're at vulnerability management scans. You can see we got two ways, we got multiple ways to get here. Okay, so there's a web application scans. We don't have any of those. And here's the vulnerability management scan. So back to the Nessus agent scan, basic agent scan. You also want to select the trigger time or the scan window, which we typically choose about 3 hours, right? So scans will automatically stop when the scan window expires. This is good, but if you see that your scans are going longer than 3 hours, then I'll show you where you want to look there, because you may want to increase your scan window, but you also may want to assess why your scans are going long. You know what I'm saying? So here we go, info level. Don't really change this at this point. Info level reporting after number of scans. This is fine. You want to schedule most times. So what I tend to like to do is weekly. I'm sorry, not weekly. That's the old way. People used to think weekly. In most situations, you want to scan for vulnerabilities on a daily basis. I used to buy into this once a month, once a quarter type of stuff. That is absolutely absurd, unless there's some really, really, really important reason why you can't do it. I recommend that you scan daily. I typically would choose around 10 a.m. The philosophy behind scanning at 10 a.m. is the fact that most machines are going to be online around 10 a.m. Choose your time zone. Notifications, typically don't do this for notifications, but you can have it to text you and you can have it to send you an email. I recommend these if you don't have a lot of scans, if you're just maintaining your companies, but this can become spammy, you know what I'm saying? So please make sure that you use this sparingly, because the last thing you want to do is not look at this. And then permissions, this shows like who can view your scan, who can execute your scan, and who can edit your scan. So if you have a team of people that are working on this, maybe you choose can edit so that other administrators or other team members in the group can edit the scan. But there are times where maybe you don't want anyone to have access to the scan. Maybe you're the only person in vulnerability management or IT or whatever, and you may have other people that just come in with reading rights or viewing rights or whatever. But either way, you can choose this different level to choose if these scans show up. And this is based on the permissions, which we will cover in some subsequent videos on Tenable. So this covers the basic agent scan. Now let's pivot and let's go to the scans and vulnerability management scans. And we're going to look at the basic network scan because there's a difference. So remember, we were on this tab before. Now we're on this tab. Okay. And so for the basic network scan, you do have to have, once again, a fundamental understanding of the network. So you're going to enter your name. Strongly recommend that you do a description. Now you have to set up, if you're going to scan internal subnet, as I mentioned before, there's some pre-setup that's required for this. So the internal scanner, this is the one that's on another machine that's on different network subnets or segments, okay? So you have to pre-configure this for this to work. The Tenable Cloud Scanner, this is if you want to scan from the internet. You can see you have scanners all over the world. So you want to choose one in your region for the particular scan that's going to reduce scan times and stuff like that. So this being the case, also you can select tags. So if you want these to only be applicable to certain groups, that means you can go in Tenable and you can add little tags to the devices in Tenable to basically be able to select them and different function in Tenable, including dashboards, reporting, scans, etc. So that's what tags are. These are actually additional information that you add to a particular device. And then you have to put in your IP address. You can see you can put in 192.168.1.1-192.168.1.255. You can do a range, or you can do what's called CIDR notation, CIDR notation, 192.168.2.0/24, which is essentially the same as putting in this range, but you in the range you can do 1 through 16, 1 through 50, whatever in range. And then you can also do domain names, once again, if you're scanning with this. But keep in mind, this is not a web application scan. If you scan a domain with this type of scan, it's going to be doing network level vulnerability scanning, not particularly application type vulnerability scanning. And then you can upload your targets in a file, which I think is a really good thing to do. Maintain that in the file and just upload it periodically, because this can be a lot to maintain. And then, of course, we talked about scheduling. You do want to schedule these. I recommend running daily unless there's some really compelling reason not to. And then the same thing, and then all the fields that we looked at before. Now, you can see we're going to go back to scans here to keep from going all the way back to the main menu. And we're going to go to what's called a host discovery scan. The host discovery scan is one that's highly recommended. The reason why is because you can't protect what you don't know about. The host discovery scan allows you to scan the subnet, once again, or network segment. And I'm saying that specifically because a lot of people may be coming into cybersecurity and may not have that networking background, but you do need to have it in order to use many of the tools like this. So same fields, same thing, internal scanner. And the main thing is in this scan, what's different is this is mostly to identify what's on your network. It's not vulnerability management scan like the basic network scan or the host or the basic host scan. The reason why that's important is because in Tenable, you have a certain amount of licenses. And so when you do a host discovery scan, it's going to detect it just like the other scans, and it's going to put it in the asset tables. But the thing to note is that these assets will not be charged against your account. So when you buy Tenable, typically you start with a block of 65 assets. Okay. And so those assets in asset tables are either licensed or unlicensed. So it's very important that you understand that when you do a host discovery scan, these do not get counted as licensed assets, even though you know about them. But the moment that you use a basic network scan or agent scan on those assets that you've identified, they become licensed. So keep that in mind, because if that is the case, then you're going to have to increase your license, which increases costs for your organization. Your organization may not want to pay for it, but if you have those assets, you probably want to scan it. Okay. So let's go back here, and that's the three main scans. Now let's look at some of the other scans that may be useful. Okay. This is one that I've been really playing with, and that's why that one's aborted. But I want to be able to identify AI. This is one that's a request that I've come across at work, and that's behind my my screen here. So let's turn on my camera. Right here, find AI. The reason why that's important is because companies are now moving to a position of, I don't want my company data being put in all these AI tools. Or you may have Grammarly, or you may have some kind of AI note taker that's on your machine. That's very important because you have to understand, just like with 23andMe and DNA or many of the other companies that have been compromised through breaches and stuff like that, if your company data is being put into any of these new AI applications that are just popping up everywhere, it's potential that your company could be compromised because this data could be compromised and they could use what's in there to attack your company. So that's why companies are trying to identify malware. But you do have a lot of other scans. I would tell you the rest of these scans are typically stuff that you use based on your specific position. So if you're in compliance, you may be doing like an internal PCI network scan here, payment card information, or those type of scans. Other things that are really helpful a lot of times is doing, when you do an advanced network scan, let's talk about that, because advanced network scans allow you to be able to configure the scan. So it says configure a scan without using any recommendations. This is why I recommend that you start with a basic, but once you get more advanced, you can go into the advanced network scans. And this is where you configure everything. But even on the basic scan, I want to show you one thing that's really important. When you're creating a basic network scan, there are advanced options. So let's go through the options of a basic network scan. So right now you can choose the ports, like what ports are discovered. Once again, knowledge of networking. If I haven't driven that point home, you definitely want that. So you can scan all ports or common ports. Common ports is a subset of ports that are basically common. They're more normal to be utilizing these. But there are times when you really want to identify everything, because if you've done any type of like hacking competition or anything like that, then you learn really fast that being able to scan all ports is really, really important for an attacker. So if you're trying to protect your organization against attacker, scanning common ports may not always be the best thing. You may want to scan all ports. In fact, it's probably recommended. Assessment, we'll click on this, and this talks about ways to scan for known web vulnerabilities. You can do a quick scan, complex scan. Once again, network-related scan, not a web application scan. Still not the same thing. Report, you can control this. The override, the normal verbosity, how much information is outputted, you can play with this. Once again, you become more advanced. These may be necessary. And then you can go to the advanced here, low bandwidth, defaults, and stuff like that. Also, credentials. This is important. This is going to be a whole video on credentials, because if you're doing a network scan and you're trying to interrogate other machines on your company network, home network, office network, whatever network, then you have to be able to authenticate to that machine, because you're connecting from the outside using a product to try to scan for vulnerabilities on that machine. And guess what? If you don't have the correct credentials, you're not going to be successful. So that's why it's important that you learn credentials, and you can add this. So I'm going to stop here. If this video was helpful, then please subscribe to the channel, because I'm going through the Tenable Vulnerability series and I'm going to try to give you common things. And then if you want deep dives and things in the future, then let me know. But I hope that you'll check out some other videos. I released a video just recently talking about patch management, which is very important. Talking about getting ready for certifications, those videos out there. So check out other videos on my channel, and I look forward to seeing you in the future. Leave comments. And if you made it to this point in the video, basic network scan. I always put this at the end of my video so I know who watched it and so I can comment, and definitely I'll shoot you an invite to Discord. Thanks for watching.